At Air Ambulance headquarters, Helimed 98 is being scrambled to the Yorkshire Dales.
MFD, easy.
So 1022.
Radio's light.
Radio's no change lights.
Autopilot.
Engaged.
Auto trim.
Engaged.
Paramedics Sammy, Steve and Dr. Tim are racing 46 miles to an injured climber.
We're going to settle. Apparently a rock has fallen on the man's head, so we're just going to find out what's going on there.
Stranded halfway up the rock face, it will be difficult to reach their patient. The local mountain rescue team are also on their way.
Do we have any further info? Over.
Steve receives an update from the scene of the accident.
Rock has hit right inside of head, taken a chunk out of it. Patient is alert, complaining of numbness down left-hand side and unable to move legs. DCA is 35 minutes away.
It sounds like the rock climber has a catastrophic head injury.
You're looking for somebody wearing blue shorts and a grey top, if you can see anything between the trees. She's also saying she's left a red bag out as some sort of marker. I don't know if you can see a red bag.
Oh, there's a red bag. Right, I can see a red bag. It's quite far up the quarry. 7 o'clock now.
Yeah, I can see it.
Yeah.
I've got somewhere to land. Looking for dust on the left. No fact at the moment.
All looks good, lad.
Yeah, I'm just going to stick it here.
The team can see the bag, but there's no sign of the patient.
I hope it's not on top of that.
We were just surrounded by a forest, and it's like, where's the guy in the forest? We didn't really have any clues as to where he was. We actually had to sort of send out a little reconnaissance mission to try and locate him.
Right, my radio, MRT radio, defib. Let's go.
Dr. Tim remains in the quarry until the location is confirmed, while Sammy and Pilot Lee search for the man from the air.
They probably are in that sloping ground because there's trees just before it.
It's a treacherous hike for paramedic Steve.
It was a rock face, but it was all loose rock, so every time you went to put your foot on, your feet were sliding back. It was a scramble up it.
Then, on the steep quarry side, he spots the patient.
Yeah, it is from Medic 2 at the patient side now, over.
Dr. Tim makes his way there with a local paramedic who's just arrived.
Right, I can see Steve up there. Steve!
Mountain Rescue reached the patient first.
Boulder's come from down there, hit him on the head. He's come down and stopped basically at this point. Not lost consciousness. We've obviously got a head injury and an eye injury. Complaining of pain in this shoulder and then numbness all the way down his left-hand side.
26-year-old Jamie Smith is badly injured. He plunged 30 feet off the rock face when the boulder hit him. Only the undergrowth broke his fall.
Just squeeze my fingers.
Can't. It's all numb.
Can you move your hand at all? Can you straighten your fingers? Can you make a fist?
Just all numb.
The numbness could be a sign of a traumatic brain injury. It also looks like he may lose his right eye.
Is that very sore in there?
Yeah. But the problem with a skull fracture is it's not the fact that your bone's broken. The fact is that if your head has been hit hard enough to fracture your skull, your little jelly-like brain underneath has obviously taken a lot of energy. And that's what happened to this guy. The actual shock of the impact had damaged the underlying brain, and that's why he was paralysed. And brain damage is often irreversible, so it's all about getting to hospital as soon as possible.
Put him in a stretcher, put him on a couple of ropes and just put some friction around and just take it down gently down this slope and then walk across to where your car is.
Right, that sounds like a great plan.
Yeah.
Can we do it as soon as possible?
Of course we can.
Thank you very much. So,
yes. So should we just get that in a
sling for now?
A sling,
yeah. Oh, he has actually dislocated his left shoulder.
Okay.
So we'll put that in a sling.
Right.
Do we have any Entonox? No.
Not here.
The mood was very tense. The things that were then going through my mind is, how on earth are we going to get this gentleman down? He had seriously possible life-changing injuries on the edge of a sheer fall down, with probably looking at maybe 30, 45 minutes of an extrication. And those patients need to be in hospital rapidly, and that was something that we couldn't do easily on this occasion.
We need to get him to hospital as soon as possible. Obviously, a horrific location. So the problem at the moment is extrication. We need to get him, using our MRT colleagues, down to the road for a full assessment and then helicopter him off to the trauma centre as soon as possible.
Mountain Rescue are ready.
Jamie, is your right arm reasonably okay for a small 200?
Yeah, his right arm, just not sure we don't knock that off of his arm. It's all his left arm that's the problem.
Ready,
Jamie, big breath. Okay, ready, steady, gentle slide.
Our plan, just so you know what it is we're just going to take him carefully down this ski slope, no real option. We're going to go slowly, put him on a rope, back rope with friction, a couple of guys are going to manage it, then the path goes diagonally across and we'll just carry it between us, because it's quite an awkward path, we'll just need lots of hands and we'll just caterpillar it across and we'll just all work together.
Keep coming steady, Jim.
Jim, you all right with that bag? Can we stick it on my shoulder?
It's taking a team of 12 people and all their strength to get Jamie out over unforgiving terrain.
So the patient is now down. We're looking to relocate the ambulance, which is just down the road, just to get better eyes in, and we couldn't really assess him much up there. And the plan is to take him over to the helicopter, which is at the golf club, and then fly him to LGI. Medic 1 from Medic 2. Yeah, we're down the bottom. We're just starting to walk across the golf course towards you now. If you can have the scoop and the flexilon out ready for us, that'd be grand. Thank you. If we just go to the back of the aircraft, guys, it'd be brilliant. We're just going to have a quick check of him before we load him up. So anywhere near the back. Down here, guys. That's here. That's great. Hi, how are we feeling? OK, so obviously we've come down quite a steep incline. Have we got any pain that we now have that we didn't have before?
No.
OK.
So air entry looks bilaterally OK. Just going to feel your chest, my friend. Sounds okay, no crepitus, so nothing to see, nothing to feel. Right, now listen, your right leg, lift your right leg straight up in the air for me.
Dr. Tim is conducting neurological tests.
That's good. Try and kick Sammy in the face.
I'm right here, buddy.
Lift your leg right up in the air.
Good lad, that'll do me.
That's good, and down. Now lift your leg, left leg right up in the air. Does it move at all? Nothing at all. Pull me towards you with this arm. Push me away. Pull me towards you with this arm. Push me away.
Just completely numb.
There is no movement on Jamie's left side. An afternoon out on a fine day has left him with potentially catastrophic injuries.
Ready, steady, lift.
Dr. Tim is arranging the hospital care his patient desperately needs.
Gently down, gently down.
Hello, this is Tim Moller, air ambulance doctor. We're flying to you and we will be getting there in about 15 minutes with a patient. Cardiovascularly, he's stable. He has no sensation or movement in the left-hand side of his body. It's been an extremely difficult extrication. It's taken us over an hour to get him away from the scene of the incident, which is why it's been so long. OK, so we'll be there in about 15 minutes.
Jamie, still with us, yeah?
Yeah.
How are we feeling?
A lot better than being up there.
Certainly.
Engine's about to fly. Confirmed.
They're racing Jamie 34 miles to the major trauma centre at the Leeds General Infirmary.
Lifted, budget, clear left.
Steve and Tim are closely monitoring their patient's condition. He may suddenly deteriorate.
98% still, pulse of 95, last BP 117.75.
Yeah, the thing about him is basically an extradural.
Yeah.
He might have got a bleed evolving on the right hand side.
Yeah. When I'm on scene with a patient, no matter how bad it is, I know what my priorities are. I look for bleeding, I sort the airway out, the breathing, the circulation. Usually I'm so focused on delivering care to those sort of parts of the body that I don't really think much about the future. Plus, if I do a good job at scene then, the future will take care of itself.
Confirm LGI in the box.
Thanks, mate.
Tell you what, thank God for MRT.
Yeah, they were amazing, actually.
Without them, we were stuffed at that job. Absolutely stuffed.
That was excellent work.
You're straight in and direct approach. In the descent, I've got the chimneys on my side.
But yeah, all looks good left.
Thanks, mate. Just maintaining that. Commit to land, over the helipad. Wooden down.
Jamie owes his life to the work of the emergency services today. But he's not out of the woods yet.
Ready, steady, slide. Happy we're clear of everything.
He's heading straight for scans and a team of waiting surgeons. Jamie Smith was rushed straight to surgery to relieve the pressure on his swelling brain after he was hit in the head by a rock while climbing. Jamie spent 3 months in hospital. He is walking again, but has been left with weakness down his left side. Doctors are hopeful that in time, he will make a full recovery.